Let's just send out a tweet so the world knows I'm broadcasting. Yes, on Twitch. Hello. I'll be with you in a second. I'm PDT and this is What's on the Tapes, another live stream. Apologies to anyone who was in expecting one at 2 o'clock today. I mean, essentially, what happened... No, that's the new one. I can't even get the showing the disaster right. I predict that today's stream is going to be crap. But thank you, welcome, hi, subscribe, etc. So... so this is what I found when I at 5 to 2 when I, hello Tom Sonic. This is what I found. I don't know how well you can see that, but the yellow one, it's stuck in there basically, and yeah, buggered. So that was fun, and I thought I've definitely got a replacement one somewhere. Started tossing around boxes, going, very kindly, Ian Lee was planning on raiding me. I need to turn raids on, actually. But, yeah, he was planning on raiding me, and he was saying, you know, are you ready? I was like, I can't even find it. Anyway, I couldn't find it. I got very hot and bothered. Went to Argos, got a replacement. You're all caught up? So... You're all here for these, aren't you? You're here for... Oh, that's some good shit. Hey, I love you. Hey, Dan. So this is what we're all here for. Someone asked me, do I check these beforehand? I think it might well have been you, Tom. Do I pre-watch the tapes? No. Generally not. Well, I mean, I never pre-watch them in any significant way. Yesterday... Wednesday I'd seen the beginning. Hey Human, hey Flora. I'd seen the very beginning of the tape because I didn't have a tape in the player to test that it was all working. I haven't actually tested it's all working now, but fingers crossed. So I saw like that it was a bit of going for gold, and I thought, oh, that'd be great. But that was it, you know. I don't, and if I rewind them, I'm not looking at it, so sometimes I rewind them. Like this one is I rewound on Wednesday. Because I was going to get round to this one. Never did. So it's B5. We are starting with B5. Hey, Daddy Dino. Lip sync is slightly out. Is anyone else suffering from slightly out lip sync? It doesn't seem to have been a problem on the recordings and things. It's okay here. Okay. Sorry, dude. Yeah, so B5. I'm hoping it's Babylon 5, because that'd be amazing. We can just watch some good television. It probably won't be B5. Babylon 5. Right. So, let's just crack straight on with it, because we all know why we're here, really. Ominous wind. Okay, so we've got a film. Thank you, Lance. I missed VHS tapes too. I so wish I had my VHS tapes from... I had so many things taped on them that probably don't exist now, but there we go. And so I had a whole booklet. I don't know if I've kept that. I might have even kept that. If I find it, I'll go through it on a stream or something. I had a whole booklet with the stuff that I'd got on it. And then it'd be like, 10 minutes stuff at the end. We all know what 10 minutes stuff was, don't we? We're all adults.
You could have stayed home and watched our...
Mo Better Blues 1990 movie. Hey, Mandy, hey, dude.
No, hey, listen, I got nothing against the brother, you know, God bless him. But,
And Dave and Brian and Matt, anyone else I missed? I'm not used to having people watching my streams. It's... Yeah, that's pretty much what I do, Tom. But the first thing I do, because I think it'd be remiss of me not to, is, you know, check the first half hour or so to see if there's any ad breaks, basically, because especially if I've not got the continuity going into it, because I've got no idea what channel it was recorded off. And we all do love an ad. An LP tape, yeah, I know. Can we all get excited? I'm having a Domino's this evening. We can get excited, Mike, but I'm not that excited because I've got work tomorrow. This is my Sunday night. I think the time, the place with Chris Morris, I think that's on YouTube, isn't it? I think the whole thing is. Your mum had an entire tape of music videos from Top of the Pops and MTV. Okay. She'd play it at parties. I mean, that's very 90s. The Landscape Channel. Crikey. Thank you, I love you. I mean, I can't take all the credit, but yeah. I mean, Dave helped kind of fire it along, and obviously Ian. But yeah, I had fun. And yeah. You know, often I'm a bit like, yeah, that could have gone better. But okay. No, I think a those were... Okay, there's clearly not ads on this. I'm at 35 minutes in. If there were going to be ads, there'd be ads by now. What was the film again? Mo Better Blues, that's the one. Mo Better Blues is 2 hours and 10 minutes. Crikey, Ro'Reilly. That is too long. No teletext on this one. How do you know? Okay, so we have an ad. Less Rainbow George is always a good thing. Yeah. Poor guy. Don't do drugs, kids. That's all I can say. When the picture rolls, you can see if there's text in the VBI area. Okay. That's crazy, man. Although, the Elgato doesn't properly show the picture rolling. So, I mean, but yeah, I mean, there may well not be. Tom Sonic is your man to talk to about teletext. I joined a Discord and tried looking into how to do it. It's beyond me. I am someone for whom Linux is a scary word, and there is a lot of Linux involved. I think there's Python. I think there's not Monty. Yeah. I realised very quickly I was out of my depth by a really long way.
Call 0891 6060 60.
Wow. Plus 1 gets you together. We are straight in. With an old age pensioners? 60-60-60? Hey, Becky, how you doing? Thank you, everyone, for dropping by the way. Oh, okay, that was... relatively easy to do. The next day, I phoned up, says you have messages waiting for... Again, it's Leeds. It's always Leeds.
Yes. We just met each other and we're married.
I think one the other day was London.
60-60-60. 1 plus 1 gets you together.
Introducing a new twist in hairstyling, Jet Spray.
Oh, thank you. I appreciate that.
Mist Spray, New Harmony Protectives Fixing Spray Plus.
Oh, okay. I did wonder where you were based.
A Golden Globe for Best Dramatic Series.
You're kidding.
Leeds very sexy. Six Emmys,
including Most Outstanding Drama.
No.
That's not fair.
But best of all, you can watch it all on Channel 4, Mondays at 10.
And 4OD, right?
Northern Exposure, The Great Outdoors.
Not 4OD.
This week on Movie Watch, we review Scent of a Woman.
Oh, for sure. For the Oscars. We also take a look at Robin Williams
playing with his toys.
Did you have to make yourself?
Chris O'Donnell, the nouveau heartthrob, will be telling us about Big Macs and method acting.
Dolly Parton's part in 95 was one that I really wanted
text.
And got away.
Mm.
Plus, an exclusive about LL Cool J.
Hi, I'm LL Cool J.
Yeah, that's exactly how the digitizer stuff is.
6 o'clock.
You're watching Channel 4.
It was a star choice, his hair, wasn't it?
For the word.
Oh, guys, we're in. Is this going to get... How explicit was the word for anyone who watched it? Do I need to just pretend that this hasn't happened? This is a relic, yeah. Well, Lance likes it. NSFW stream.
The word.
Tame than late night sea fart. Yeah, even so.
Ice T shows off his weapon. Schlock horror star Phoebe Legere displays her accordion, and there's music from Delench Mob, Jamiroquai, and Moni Love.
The word.
I feel like the trashy horror star could be. Who's that? What was her name? Dani Behr? Of course, Dani Behr! Where's Dani Behr now? You can. It's a Panasonic. I'll tell you later. It's a Panasonic and it's just kind of dark because my room doesn't have the best lighting. She's had massive plastic surgery and lives in LA. Dani. Oh yeah, I see what you mean. That seems like a shame. But there we go. As long as she's happy.
News to me, that's Dani there.
Dani Behr looked like your first girlfriend, you braggart, Lance.
And welcome to the word. I should say as well, to start off with, thanks to all
this, this is the remote that I'm using. Actually, that pretty good, should they?
If you're watching, mate, if you want to be me,
oh no, it's just for this VCR TV.
Like 15 quid and a free breakfast poster. And I could do all your adverts in that opera show, and I'd have loads of money, wouldn't I?
Anyway, Adam Buxton said, when I watch the musical performance, I miss the word until I remember what the rest of the world was like, and then I don't miss it.
First time here in Britain, Delench Mob and Freedom Got an AK.
This was your childhood as a raver twink. I mean, I can't even take in the everything that's happening on screen. Some Adam and Joe would be a welcome find. Yeah, I mean, who knows what I'm going to find, but... Swears are okay on Twitch, Tom. They're fucking welcomed. Yeah. You bunch of shits. But nipples are a no-no. Definitely colourful and sensory fun for an ADHD kid. Yeah, I've got to admit, it's just noise to me. I mean, I think they said something about mukbang. Yeah. There we go.
Oh, yes.
You may have watched this when it was... I imagine a lot of people did.
The lynch mob, Freedom Got an AK. Now, our first guest tonight, it's probably said now, our first guest tonight, more than anybody in the studio.
Michael Parkinson.
He's got more jackets than Spud you like, and I'll tell you this, my mum liked him a lot better than Terry Wogan, but not as much as she liked me.
Oh, it's Wassy, isn't it?
32-year-old Jonathan Ross was raised in East London, and it was obvious from an early age that he had star quality.
Full of goodness and lots of fun.
Jonathan's cheeky Cockney confidence caught the eye of Channel 4 chiefs, who gave him his own show. The last
early 90s, yeah.
Greetings and welcome to the show.
The psychedelics were what most viewers did after getting in from the pub.
Fresh air. If you do that again, I'm going to thump you, all right? And I'm not joking, so put it down and behave yourself.
Mystic Meg there, I think, as well.
Gentlemen, please welcome Jonathan Ross. Oh, Jonathan!
Pass, who, man?
This alternative host soon hit the personal appearance circuit and revealed all in
I guess
Hello
we'll
magazine.
Find out.
He's currently chief zookeeper on his brand new Saturday night show, but what will he reveal tonight? Welcome to the word, Jonathan.
Cancelled. God, was he was on Letterman? I guess so.
Wait, Terry, you did not warn me. You did not tell me just how gorgeous the crowd would be.
Jonathan Ross and Terry Christian on the word. Is there anything more 90s than this?
Almost stiff at the thought of doing an interview with you in front of them.
I know, you were grabbing your crotch at the beginning. But you missed that shot of your bare behind there.
I've seen it all before in the mirror.
Have you? I see, is that when
you're shaving?
Do you like that shot, though? Do you like that shot in particular, do you?
No, I just thought that it was quite a brave thing for you to do, really.
What are you getting at?
Never mind, listen, we're going to go back to your showbiz career, because you started very young, didn't you? You did, like, adverts and everything.
I did some adverts when I was a kid.
I've got to say, Terry Christian was not a charming presence on screen. And putting Jonathan Ross next to him only, like, exaggerates that, doesn't it?
But we were fumbling around the background. But I can remember very little about him, Terry, to be honest with you. I was just a tiny little child, no bigger than your thumb.
No, that's a lie. I mean, you must have been about 11, 12, something like that.
The Rice Krispies I did when I was about 7. I really can't remember much about it, but if you say I was 12, then maybe I was 12, Terry.
Is that how you got bitten with the bug?
The last resort.
Bitten with the bug. No, because I really didn't particularly think... I think we did that just because we were big family and someone said you should maybe, you know, they're looking for big families for that kind of thing. It wasn't really... We weren't really a kind of showbiz family at all. But I got into TV a different way altogether. I was working behind the scenes on shows similar to this one, booking guests. And then someone said maybe you should give it a go.
Yeah, I mean, especially for a long play tape, Tom.
Very professional.
You know, it's good. Most of the tapes that I've picked up seem to be in good condition. Is that a cheeseburger phone on the table?
Just feels sort of not quite right, Terry.
I feel like we should move on just because we could sit here and watch the word for an hour and it would be great. But it's not really in the spirit of tape discovery. FBI's national threat list. I don't remember The Last Resort, but then he's done a lot of TV shows, as you say.
And what's Daddy got parked next to your bedroom, little Ice?
Right next to your child's bedroom.
Yeah, right next to the bedroom. Here you got good pump shot, pump action shot, man.
Well, yeah, there's the gun. Oh, is that Katie Puckrick?
With or what?
Yeah. Pigeon shoot. This is another good thing to shoot pigeon with. It's called an M16 assault rifle.
Now, this is just a little bit... like overkill, I think.
But this is overkill.
Gosh.
This is your heckler and Koch.
You watch the word for the music and the swearing.
Semi-automatic. Yeah. Oh. 80 round clip, ladies.
And Ice-T just showing us his gun collection. Here I come. Wow. There we go, there's ads. And I think are sponsored by Swatch Bumper.
Or Angie Bowie. Find out after the break.
Hang on, so what's the question? People watch the word for the interviews like people read Playboy for the articles. Yeah.
The word.
Which blonde superstar gave her 15-year-old son condoms and a sex education book as a present to celebrate his first date? Was it Joan Rivers, Margaret Thatcher, Ivana Trump, or Angie Bowie?
Place bets now.
The break.
Spread the word.
At the moment, it's only going through the Elgato, Tom. When I'm doing it like privately, I have it on the TV as well, so I can see the fast forwards and stuff. I'm thinking Joan Rivers.
By carrying a donor card, you're offering the gift of life. But if you haven't told your next of kin, whose consent will be asked, it could turn out to be an empty gesture.
Harsh. Word is sort of a forerunner to the 11 o'clock show, sounds the music and the comedy, I would say. Angie, but I know that Dave knows his music. So I'm guessing Angie Bowie is the answer, is it?
Oh no!
There we go. It's supposed to be doing that.
Have a Kit Kat.
No, I think that was the point, Tom. I think the point of the advert was that... Hang on, was who David Tennant? I mean, he would have been very young at this point, so I'd be surprised. But yeah, it's not a breakdown, that's the planned advert. Could you hear the guy rushing in and going, ah? Because he's having a break.
No.
Have a break. Have a Kit Kat.
I mean, I don't think you see enough of him to be able to say. Maybe.
No, grazie.
Yeah, doing a few frames between each advert makes it very easy when I'm trying to cap an individual advert, because yeah, one man can take it back. I get a nice clean one. Under siege at cinemas now. Yeah, I mean, I think later tapes that I've got, and not that much later, do them straight into each other.
With its new lines, the ZX turns heads even when it's standing still.
Is that him again?
On the move, the ZX sets new standards in his class for ride and handling.
Okay, we're around 93. Cool.
Everything about it says quality.
First, surf in a box. Now, surf in a bag. There's no change.
These guys are excellent when I'm on stream for finding out what date stuffs are on.
Because thanks to the eco bag, surf now saves you even more. So it's cheaper than any other leading concentrated powder. Surf.
And if they don't work out exactly what day it is, when I put it up on YouTube, someone will definitely tell me.
Ain't no IOUs when you pay DD.
It is scary how much the people of YouTube seem to know. And I always reply saying, how do you know this? It depends on how much is on the tape, but I'm planning on streaming till 9, so hopefully we'll get to at least one or two more tapes.
The answer is Ivana Trump.
Oh!
They came in handy.
Dave, you failed me, man.
Welcome back. Still with us, of course, Jonathan Ross. Don't phone, it's just for fun.
That's Chris
brilliant.
No, that's Chris Evans.
I just think it's a good one. We've got a few.
Wow. Oh, thank you for the sub, Brian. Yes, of course, you can subscribe. Bits, donations, YouTube, Twitter, all those things. I am fast forwarding on a bit because I think we want to see more tapes. I mean, I will go through this at some point, and I think, and even if I don't upload the whole thing to YouTube, I'll definitely be looking for clips because. It's bugging me. Oh, thank you, Gareth.
Have all your years of experience.
Yeah, 6 years I've been doing the job now, and they are very, very varied. Yeah.
Now, anything you can warn these guys against, or what to beware of?
Basically, like they say in the Girl Guides, just to be prepared, because every day is very, very different. But the marriage proposals don't come in amiss now and again. You never know your luck.
Oh.
Yeah, thank you, man. It all helps. Like, one day I might get a payout from Twitch, which. I think you have to hit a certain threshold, it sort of... Oh, well, that's awkward. I think you might have to, man, because I don't have the hardware, I think. Because I've got a second laptop that I could try doing the whole Linux thing on, but... Yeah. I don't have the Win TV card, and I don't know what I'm doing when I'm messing around inside laptops.
At length after the break, we'll be back with Moni Love, who'll be giving us a bit of chat on the couch, and also giving us her latest single. And we've also got some. Oh, you'll see later.
There was actually an artist called Moni Love.
See you then.
Come on.
Spread the word.
Whose breasts swelled up so much that one of them popped out live on a Mexican television show? Was it Gloria Estefan, Melanie Griffith, Lindy Sinclair, or Jamie Lee Curtis? Find out.
Hello, any guesses for whose breasts swelled up?
When two women offered to wash my hair, I thought they're only after one thing. They were my dandruff microbes, the irritating little blighters that cause the flakes. That's why they're washing half my head with this and half with Head and Shoulders.
Okay.
To demonstrate how it gets rid of the dandruff by neutralizing those troublesome microbes. On the ordinary medicated side, still dandruff. How irritating. But on the Head and Shoulders
time for me to join the stream. Absolutely. Hey, Rob. Rampant.
Head and Shoulders doesn't half shift dandruff.
Oh, I'm so excited. Oh, classic. I think we all remember this ad, Tom. Who does CCO Gamer? I don't think I know CCO Gamer.
That Friday feeling.
But thank you. You're very welcome.
Take the wheel of the new Peugeot 405 with its unique ICD road handling system, and you know you've had this feeling before—a feeling of total control. And the confidence to handle whatever the world throws at you.
Car ads and beer ads. There is something about those which just... Yeah, they always tend to be better than most other adverts, don't they?
Your breath away.
Sometimes.
New Glade Plug-ins air freshener.
Plug it in, plug it in.
It keeps on fragrancing your
These
room.
These car ads are always so funny in retrospect.
Plug
yeah.
It in, plug it in. New Glade Plug-ins freshens.
Oh, do they?
By gently warming this
retail. They still play that song on the ride at the end at Cadbury World.
If you've tried to give up smoking, you know how difficult it can be. The craving just won't go away. You can't concentrate. You're irritable. Your fingers have little to do. You may put on some weight.
This is 93, we think.
Now's the time for Nicorette. Because if you're determined to quit, Nicorette will help you beat your craving, leaving you free to give up smoking. Nicorette patch or gum, both available.
Yeah, so if any the people who have just come in, what this is, I bought a load of VHS tapes off eBay, and we're just finding out together what's on them. That's it. Now, it's as simple as that.
Color and light pressed powder, so your finish stays flawless and fresh.
And you know, you'll find previous streams on my YouTube channel up there. The other day, we found the broom cupboard with Andy Crane doing kids' TV.
To get rid of your dandruff, don't worry.
You have some videos from this era. Yeah.
25% faster.
Well, there's only so much that makeup ads can say, really, isn't there? Alright, let's find out whose boobs swelled up.
We asked you, whose breasts swelled up so much that one of them popped out on a live Mexican television show? The answer is Gloria Estefan.
There we
she
go.
She said she was too hot, but maybe the dress was too small.
What you usually do is fast forward the tape all the way to the end, then clean off the mould and dirt off the inside of the VCR. I mean, I've not really got a measure in place for dealing with mould and dirt beyond a VHS head cleaner. I guess the word was the last program that evening. Ouch. I almost certainly have got to close down, Tom. Ah, thank you for the host, Nexus. 5th of March 1993, there we go. Thank you, Dave. Oh, come on. Clearly, I vastly overestimated how long the word is. Or how much longer we had to go. Oh, for God's sake. Look, we just want to see a continuity announcer... Well, hear a continuity announcer going, that's all from Channel 4 for tonight. See you tomorrow. And then not the national anthem, because, you know, Channel 4 was rebellious. No ITV night screens yet. I've come across some ITV nighttime stuff, but no ITV night screens just yet. Here we go. Go to bed, Spotty. Yeah, I think this is from the Adam batch of tapes, which has given us... They seem to do a lot of just leaving the tape running. I don't get the reference, but I'm happy to repeat it and hope that it's not some alt-right message. Oh, young ones. Didn't realize Planet 24 did that.
I wish my dad was here. Oh, I don't.
Come on, Mike!
Time to call him!
Go, Planet. I'm coming, Dad, I'm coming. See you, kid.
Please don't fall.
There's no place for you here.
Distant voices, still lives. A moving tale of family hope and despair. Tuesday's award-winning film on 4 at 10.
I was born in 84, Tom.
And that's it for tonight, or should I say this morning. Later on, we've got...
it's tonight, because you've not gone to bed yet. From you didn't talk me up.
Then at 9, it's episode 3 of Dennis Potter's Lipstick on Your Collar, and Private Francis has a private fantasy about Sylvia, the girl upstairs. At 10 past 10, Vanessa Redgrave stars with Sarah Miles and Diana Dawes as a woman opening up her heart along with her paws while steaming. And at 5 to 12, a film from Mali on the clash of cultures in the Third World. Now, over the time at 28 minutes past 3, from us all here at 4, have a good night.
I can quite honestly say I do not remember Filthy Rich and Catfap. I think that was a completely different programme. But yeah, I've not really watched The Young Ones, so yeah, I've not seen the sequel series. So that's it. And I suspect that might be all of the tape, but... So I think that's one where it's music replacements, isn't it, with on the DVD. Okay. I don't know what that was, but I'm very glad that the video didn't kick in. Just
did not show up on the scan, so we don't know whether it's a boy or a girl. I mean, we're half expecting that it's going to be a girl, so that's really nice. And if it's a boy, it'd be an even bigger surprise for us both.
Okay, that wasn't what it sounded like. Although the woman is kind of half nude, let's just rewind a bit.
No, she said she wanted the epidural.
Unfortunately, she.
What is this? And why was there like 15 minutes of close down before it? I have so many questions now.
Arthur.
I think this is way too old for that, isn't it?
So I went out to get the nurse.
And they left the tape on an auto stop timer, maybe, yeah. I mean, who knows why half the things that are on these tapes are in the way that they were. I mean, I know we've got some excellent shirts going on, I'm just not sure what the program is. Okay. Just clearing out your ears. Is it some of the educational stuff they'd show in the, I don't know, because this is a, you know, it's not a natural cut, so.
When we'd got married, and we had been trying since we were married, and it just didn't seem as if it was.
You have tinnitus in one ear. It's just like that. My apologies, Chris.
We went to a private clinic and had an ultrasound scan done. They said, no, everything's fine. The baby's not moving a great deal, but the baby is moving.
No, we've so gone into SP.
Feeling quite relaxed and quite comfortable.
Due date was another 5 days, so we really didn't think much more of it. We had a lovely evening, our last evening, really just the two of us. Halfway through the night, Judy woke up saying my water's broken.
I don't know what this is.
I ran down to the video shop and got the long version of Lawrence of Arabia so we could sit in front of that while Judy was having her contractions.
Lawrence of Arabia, as Ricky Gervais once said on the 11 o'clock show.
Before we started to kind of have.
Seems like it is a very bad porno, if I'm honest.
Doing all the things that the NCT class had taught us to do.
It's almost not erotic at all.
Wrong way round. See the leg up, a leg down, everything was all
just talking us through childbirth, because why not?
Bacon.
Well, my first reaction was to look at his face and think, I hope he hasn't got my nose.
He looked just like a tadpole.
General MacArthur.
Clip that. No, I mean, I will clip that, because what?
Well, you'd be bored too.
Confessions of a window cleaner, yeah. I mean, what? I don't even know what you're on about, mate.
From this waxy stuff that they covered in the womb, covered in blood. She really just looked like a giant rash of bacon.
Well, my first reaction was to look at his face and think, I hope he hasn't got my nose.
He looked just like a tadpole.
Looked like General MacArthur.
I don't know why that makes me laugh, but
idea.
Just like John Major, but I don't think there's any connection.
He's a big baby. I mean, it'd be about.
This is a very off program.
£7.
Is that the old man from the Geronimo condom? I have no idea.
The weight of a baby. The rest of your life.
It was hilarious when I was kicked. I was told not to watch them, so I did. Yeah.
15 stone or something.
I don't think they're talking about the same baby, Tom.
How much baby weighs? Do they want to know how much pain the wife went through?
35-year-old John Kinch is congratulated on being the father of an outsized baby boy.
I mean, so far I've noticed there's absolutely no women being interviewed in this programme. That must smash a great many What the hell is this?
intensive care then, and we realised how bad Harriet was. Her arms were she was having muscle spasms, and her arms were twisted out of shape, and so were her legs.
It has the similar Talking Head style of I Love the 80s, but instead of talking about space hoppers, they're talking about births. Yeah. What?
What we didn't realise was that it took her, it was going to take some time.
Yes, it's very frustrating.
We sat and held her.
A few people, I know the TV museum has access to various listings and things, but yeah, I don't.
I knew it was going to be a long night.
It's because women was too busy in the kitchen cooking dinner for the entire meal. I mean, who knows?
And I said, Mrs. Conley, what ward is she in? He said, and some girl there, some nurse said, oh, she's already in delivery right now.
Joking. So give me the gas, give me the gas.
I mean, presumably, whatever, it's a documentary about being a dad in the whole process.
Why don't you go in? I said, oh, no, I don't want to go in, thank you. I'm you know, I'm very timid about these things.
I was quite happy to be up the right end, you know, and pat her for
bloke stepping off the buses on YouTube under a video titled Champion Heavyweight Baby.
The delivery room was a sort of porthole.
Okay.
And you could pull it back and look in. She said, I can't hold it anymore. I've got to push. I feel as if I'm going to explode. And I look in and I can see.
It may date from the 80s. I mean, it may be repeated. Who knows?
And they're saying, come on, push, dear, push. So she pushed, I think.
I mean, yeah, I think this is the programme that they were recording over. But it's all right. There's no nipples. It's fine.
Are you happy with your little family?
Yes, honey. This is everything I've worked for. Is my family happy with me?
Once more, we're feeling, mate.
You've been a wonderful father.
I haven't, Dave, no. Hey, Tara.
And coming up next, birth reports.
What? Birth reports?
We went to the Mozart concert, and about 10 minutes before the end of the concert, I felt and heard this very loud pop in my tummy, and thought...
So it was BBC 93.
And I told my husband, and his immediate reaction was that we should go home and get to the hospital. And I said, no, no, I haven't had anything to eat since lunchtime. We must go out to dinner, as we planned to do.
Well, hang on, I guess if this is BBC, we can look it up on Genome, can't we?
And we had a fantastic Italian meal, huge pasta, and... the waiters were rather worried that I was in labour, which my husband told them, but they were very sweet and they gave us a pudding, tiramisu, on the house, which filled me up.
Ah, okay, this is 28th of April, 1993, so it's later than...
Guy was born about 4 hours later.
Or possibly not.
I'd been 3 days in labour, and consequently...
Oh, it was originally shown during BBC Two's Birth Night Evening.
During the middle of the third night after I'd had the baby, I remember not being able to sleep at all.
No, TV RDB is the repeat.
I had a very strange visitor at the bottom of the bed.
Yeah, childbirth night.
Who said good evening and started a conversation with me. He was saying about how I now had some of his blood running in my veins. And because of this, I would have picked up a bit of his personality. So, in future, I was going to love football. The next visitor I had was
I mean, the one problem with Genome is that...
old-fashioned way, who actually floated out of the corner of the room.
Things haven't always been written very well on there.
I did speak to her, but she didn't answer. I thought, this is very, very strange indeed.
I think it's possible they got prisoners in to do it or something.
Things weren't quite right. When a 12-inch fairy mouse came and sat just at the end of the bed and looked up at me. He was dressed in an opera cape and a top hat. He said, good evening.
Took off his top. This is a bizarre show. Yep, no worries, Tyra. Enjoy.
And disappeared underneath the bed. I presume on the way to the opera.
Well, I don't know if this is actually a programme, is it? It seems to be...
a very, very difficult birth. And when the first baby was born... it was born dead. They threw a sheet over my face so that I couldn't see what was happening.
BBC Two's birth night evening.
Lived only for, I think, only a few minutes, really. And then it died.
Right, here we go.
Well, the
27th of February 1993, that makes more sense.
Having had this huge stomach and the contractions that were coming were really, I don't recall any pain, certainly any pain worse than that. And I just lay there, and of course in those, now this is 50 years ago, in those days they didn't leave a nurse with you to keep
so,
company and comfort you.
That programme was It's All Right, Darling, I'm Here.
Lying there.
The examination of birth from a male perspective includes recent real-life experiences of fatherhood and some archive film clips of worried fathers, from a terrified Michael Crawford to a petrified James Stewart.
Were my two babies. Their faces.
So then I think we've got special deliveries in a second, and then it's into Rosemary's Baby.
They were all right. They were happy. And I've been happy about them ever since. And,
I've got to admit, I thought it was the White House.
I've always said that I had fun.
And the last shot was Doctor Who drowning. But no, I guess she's too old. Well, Mary Whitehouse would have been. I think Mary Whitehouse.
Birth night on BBC Two. The night shift is on duty now at Homerton Hospital, and they're hoping for a quiet patch. But an emergency
It's buffering.
Doesn't leave much chance of that. Special deliveries.
It's okay. We're back. We're hopefully back. I don't know. It just blipped. But it did mean that you probably missed a special BBC Two ident. You got it. But we can watch it again.
Birth night on BBC Two. The night shift is on duty now at Homerton Hospital, and they're hoping for a quiet patch. But an emergency caesarean doesn't leave much chance of that in the last of our special deliveries.
That's really cool. The Mary Whitehouse I never saw the Mary Whitehouse experience,
now she's
but...
pregnant. The baby's reached an age of viability. Because it's a precious pregnancy, she's having an elective.
Let's see if there's another birth night ident at the end of it. Because this is just a 10-15 minute programme, so. It's the last of the evening special report from some hospital. All Mary Whitehouse are on YouTube. No, well, I guess they wouldn't have reused that. Yeah, like the. Actually, I think that even the Red Dwarf one's got a bit of reuse.
Off because I wanted to see her and touch her, and a nurse suddenly came crashing in through the curtains and said, "What are you doing? What are you doing?" And I said, "Well, I'm just trying to look at my baby." And she said, "Oh, you mustn't."
So this is those recollections again.
But this time we actually did retrieve it because my fear was very.
So that's why there was a compilation a few months later of all of these little 5 minute.
About it, and I put it in the freezer, and then I. Cut off lumps and I.
Yeah, YouTube gets quite funny about copyright for old stuff sometimes. It's. Let's see the ident going into that. Let's see that again. Oh.
Film,
same one.
Baby, a nightmare journey into witchcraft and Satanism in New York. On its original release in 1968. One critic suggested that pregnant women should see it at their own risk. Let that be a warning.
You once managed to watch all of Punt and Dennis on YouTube, then they took it off. Well, fair enough. I mean, Tom, you're playing a different game to me, mate. I'm just looking at VHS tapes, and if it gets clogged, I put a head cleaner on. That's it. But then I suppose if you're capturing teletext, you need to keep it as clean as possible, I suppose.
She was very romantic. Terribly difficult to keep clean.
Like, I'm just winging this. I mean, a few people have asked me now, Pete, what? How are you cataloguing these? I'm like, some of them I'm cataloguing, depending on what mood I'm in at the time. Just on a Google. Anyone? Oh, is that the Wembley Arena?
She's playing a game with us. With you.
Odd, isn't it? You hate the past. We cling to it.
This summer, they...
What the muddy funkster is this? I mean, I don't know, actually, is this carrying on the evening from... No, because according to this, there wasn't any more evening. Diplomatic immunity. Oh, right, that's what the trailer's for, isn't it? No, because that's 2009. Yeah, I mean, I'm going to try and capture what I can and then... Right, okay. I'm going to try and capture what I can. If I can upload it to YouTube, I will. If they take it down.
For Cuckoo,
I'm
and Sir Archie Peverell,
really bad at quite a lot of this reference stuff. It's...
Darling, what a divine boy. Isn't he?
He shares her secret.
Maybe she's playing a game with us.
There are a lot of things that I haven't seen that people would expect me to have seen.
We cling to it.
Oh, come on.
They relive it. Anouk Aimée and Joss Ackland from Dirk Bogarde's novel Voices in the Garden. Next week, Screen 2, Sunday at 10.
Maybe a secondary YouTube account for the IFIA stuff. Yeah, maybe.
For the same price as a day's BBC,
what's going on?
You can travel 320 yards in a black cab. The BBC, the best value television and radio.
I'm going to have to upload that, aren't I? I mean... That's timely if ever there was one.
Richard Kiley, Edward Andrews and John McIntyre star in the tough thriller concerned with the sleazy underworld of small-town America in the 50s. That's in 25 minutes here on BBC Two, The Phoenix City Story.
93 still. Yeah, I figured it probably would be.
First on BBC Two, a lighter look at life with Dave Thomas.
Gosh. I mean, is that Tiffany Amber Thiessen?
Sorry.
Bye.
The money now could get you a taxi home and back a few times. What? No, you're not misremembering. I came across an ITV one on Channel 4 the other day. This is terrifying. Okay. Yeah, I might look into that, Rob. Please, Pete. Always Pete. Or PDT, but never Peter.
Thank you very much, ladies and gentlemen.
Even my parents don't call me Peter now.
Welcome to the show. You know, prior to the show, I was just watching a video of the classic Western Shane in my dressing room, and my favorite actor in that movie is not Alan Ladd, but the villain.
The Dave Thomas Comedy Show was a sketch-based half-hour, 5-week summer replacement series, which aired on CBS in the summer of 1990. The show starred Canadian comedian Dave. Try saying that 10 times fast. Dave Thomas, who is best known for an earlier sketch comedy series, SCTV.
Except for maybe this guy. I mean, he's the only guy who might be able to top Jack in the scary division. Anyway, I'm glad he's back in the limelight. Remember his television show, Believe It or Not?
He was great presenting the bizarre, I do get that reference.
Items, but when it came to the lighter items, Jack's scary delivery was way over the top. Like, the tiny dick-dick antelope of Kenya.
When they're telling me off,
member of the horse family.
I mean, that's dreadful. Oh, I've overshot the end.
Crime and corruption in small...
Didn't Bill Hicks talk about Shane and Jack Palance, but better. I imagine so.
Complimenting each other all night, right?
Dave, we were just going to get to you.
One season only, wonder why. I mean, it's being shown at... I'm assuming this is very late night BBC Two.
Oh, thanks. Good night, everyone.
Mind you, Seinfeld was shown very late night BBC Two, so... I guess that's no indication of quality. John LeBlanc.
Dave Thomas's guests include Martin Short and Chevy Chase.
Oh, of course, Catherine O'Hara, the mum from Home Alone. Hey, Gemma. One too many, quite possibly. Yes.
If I have to think about sex one more time, I'm just going to faint.
Biscuits.
Yes.
You have a herb nub. Swedish for hob nob.
Yes.
And rock and roll.
It's all right.
My eyes love will flame.
1989, that's... Well, hang on, no, the show was 1990.
9 o'clock.
Oh, yeah.
On BBC Two.
And that was in America, so...
You work all year for this 2 weeks.
Sun, sun, swill, sex, sex, sex.
There's no harm in it. The boys just have a good time.
That's the three definitely biscuits.
You kind of do it
biscuits
now.
Are the most reliable.
You'll be able to do it. You only hear once, aren't you?
Away the lads. 40 minutes, Tuesday at 9:50 on BBC Two.
Get yourselves down there right now if you want to...
November Rain Gag, and that song came out in 92. Yeah. We're probably still in 92, 93.
America is the backdrop now on BBC Two as a young lawyer attempts to break the reign of mob violence.
So I suppose the question is, were they specifically recording the Dave Thomas show? I mean, there's no accounting for taste. Or were they just recording everything? I guess that awful comedian show took a few years to be shown over here. Yeah. Okay, March 93. Now, we are getting to the very end of the tape. I can hear it winding down, so don't worry. We will be going on to a second tape. I am going to cut it off pretty strict about cutting off at 9 tonight, because I'd quite like to watch an episode of Picard before Ian and Kath are on at 10. We've reached the end. I'm a bit behind on Picard, so no spoil. Well, I kind of know what's going on, but... Yeah, I think I've still got episode 5 to watch before episode 6, which was this week's one. Right, we have... So we have... Now, I might have looked at this one, I'm not sure. Let's... So we have a few tapes to choose from. We have a Samsung, number 3. Finding Picard a little funny, very slow. We have a Maxell number 25. And we have a Polaroid blank. Any preferences, guys? Any preferences? Oh, do you mean the beginning, Who Man? Speak now or forever hold your peace, and it'll probably be on another stream at some point. Or anything good in it will end up at YouTube anyway. I've only watched three so far. No spoilers, don't worry. Tom says Polaroid. Polaroid. Any of them have the little stickers on the labelling as mum's tape? Not yet, but... blank for more mystery. I mean, I don't know. Can you get much more mystery than 25 and 3? But I take your point. So my only worry is that I think I've looked at some of these. Not necessarily on stream, but I think I looked through some of the box.
Particularly when I look at some of your well-known dishes.
I try and take
local ingredients
wherever possible, but obviously there aren't that many original.
So I have looked at this.
But we have...
So I probably will put one of the other two in a sec, but... just so we can see a little bit of MasterChef. I mean, this one's dealing really well with... sometimes when I'm rewinding, it shows it quite well, but... alright, let's... oh, now it disappears. No, but many of the Memorex tapes squeak and rub now. Okay. Yeah, Lloyd Grossman era. I think this is the batch of tapes that I got the 94. Yeah, because this is where I got the net from. Stop the tape? Why am I stopping the tape? SP, yeah, SP is better.
Bridegroom.
Do I have to go to me stag night?
Oh, you'll be all right. There'll be me Uncle Seymour and some of his mates.
Do you think he's alive to the responsibilities of wedding?
Do you think he's alive?
And a predatory mother-in-law.
It's all right, Sarah. We're going to see some MasterChef.
Fair woman. We only wore it once.
Nuptial Pursuits in Last of the Summer Wine, tonight at 7 on BBC
One. But this is the batch of tapes which contained... there's a 90s show called The Net, and it's sort of a bit Tomorrow's Worldy, but just for the internet-based stuff.
And I was very happy to take children that would probably have...
and very early on, I posted some clips of a crap video game review. It was like a 13-year-old girl called Jules. Really 90s. And there's a few... yeah, that's where that came from. And there's a few more of those.
Because that's what a parent's all about.
There's a version of Extended Play for Pam, but it's
very... Tuesday at 8 on BBC One. Now on BBC One, more amateur chefs practice their culinary skills as they compete for the title MasterChef.
I felt like his voice is really going there. Yeah, MasterChef was very much chilled Sunday afternoon fare. Not the high intensity competition it is now. No Adams are yet, Dave, but we can always hope.
Welcome to MasterChef 1994. This week our three competitors come from the southeast of England.
They're whatever happened to Lloyd Grossman?
And beyond that,
hopefully
the title
nothing.
Of MasterChef 1994, the best amateur
There's
cook
a guy
in
called
Britain.
Techmoan who finds these really
Derek
obscure
Jordan
audio, but also video formats.
Manchester. Every year the southeast
I
of
think
England
it might
has
been
the
slow
largest
motion,
number
Tom.
Of applicants for MasterChef. But so far, none of them has won the title.
I'll have to
but
look up Techmoan.
Maybe this year, one of these will. As always, they have just 2.5 hours to cook us a championship.
Also, look at the Found Footage Festival. They do a show called VCR Party Live on YouTube, and there's just, I mean, they're American, so it's mainly American stuff. But
this evening, we have two Sophies. In the Red Kitchen, Sophie number one, that's Sophie Buckman. She lives in Uckfield, East Sussex, in an until recently derelict Regency mansion, with her three friends
and
co-restorers, Keith, Garnet, and Edward, as well as a considerable number of
Yes,
animals.
He does, because I had one last year.
Here's the pool.
There you go. Lloyd Grossman still sells his cooking sauces. Or at least Tesco does.
They're keen that however long the rest of the venture takes, Sophie will soon be able to start cooking in her new kitchen. In the yellow kitchen,
yeah. We're going to watch a little bit of MasterChef because people want to. And then I'm going to go on to another one.
Training manager for a pharmaceutical company, where she's also responsible.
Because I've not done this on stream, but I have done it.
For those not in the know, that stands for good clinical practice.
I haven't ripped everything off it yet, but yeah.
Elaine's good physical practice.
Basically, my tape system is increasingly muddled boxes on the other side of the room. It's a fucking mess, and I'm really.
Our sofa full of Sophies,
help me, guys.
17-year-old Sophie Maskey from Shoreham by Sea in Sussex. Sophie left school at the end of last year, and she's currently working on Marks and Spencer while she seeks out a possible
patronizing
career catering. Sophie loves messing about in boats. She's an enthusiastic dinghy sailor.
Aren't we all?
But her pride and joy is her silver mini, which regularly benefits from Sophie's tender, loving care. Welcome to all of you. Now it's time to find out what you're going to be cooking for us this evening. Sophie, tell us about your menu.
Yeah, no, I absolutely won't be letting any go until everything good's been captured off them. But do you ever come to London, Tom? Because otherwise I don't know how I'm going to get them all to you.
Beetroot plum and sherry vinegar sauce. Bounded by leaves of patrick.
I did think that I love you.
Rosemary scented pomme dauphinoise,
like a young
and
woman.
Spinach and horseradish. For pudding, cream of coconut ice cream in a citrus tulle with a ginger and lime butterscotch sauce.
I might eat that menu backwards because I love coconut ice cream. Elaine, what's on your menu?
I'll be cooking
that's not the format, Lloyd.
With baby salad leaves and a chive vinaigrette, followed by saddle of wild rabbit in a juniper and hermitage sauce. And seasonal vegetables, and then to finish, a muscat and pelargonium tart with an elderflower scented cream.
Ah, okay.
Pelargoniums or pelargonia are what I've got in my garden, I see.
Scented leaf geranium, yeah.
Oh, exciting. Good. And Sophie number two, what are you cooking?
I'm cooking salmon tart in a herb butter sauce, followed by poached guinea fowl in a quince and white wine sauce, with celeriac and potatoes and spinach in a noisette butter. And to finish with glazed almond and coconut puddings in a citrus sauce.
I don't know, Dave. I was just wondering that myself. Why are they making them read it out? Like, especially that stilted facing the camera way.
Have a really good time, and let's get cooking.
This is MasterChef for Blind Day. Yeah, I mean, you say that it had to change, but this went on for quite a few years. But yeah, MasterChef now bears no resemblance to this. Seemingly at gunpoint, yeah. Don't like the sound of any of them. It's alright, we already know the tape cuts off in about 2 minutes, so...
Tucked away in a remote corner of North Wales, described as a restaurant with rooms and called Place Bodegros, is the home of this evening's guest chef, Christopher Chown. It's a gastronomic oasis in a fairly
barren
land.
That lady looks a bit like Olivia Colman.
I'm going to make a warm salad of monkfish.
All right, I don't want to see the... I've got to say, it took me back as well. I mean, I was never much of a fan of this programme, but my mum used to watch it fairly religiously.
Trout wrapped in bacon. And now it's become a bit of a signature dish, really. I can't take it off my menu because the guests want me to keep it there.
Tell me, Chris.
And they both look thrilled about it.
Celebrated for, certainly for its restaurant.
Cooking does not get
Was
tougher
it very
than this.
To establish a top-class restaurant there?
Enormously difficult. I was 28.
It's nostalgic music, but it is still bad. Yeah, I'll give you that.
Which probably helped me because it meant I could go into a local bank and persuade the manager that he actually wanted
help set up.
Everyone seems so sad. Well, it's Sunday, isn't it?
Nowhere to a man with no track record whatsoever.
I mean, this is my Sunday evening. This is what I'm doing with it. So,
he came up with
this week.
How would you characterise your cooking? Because it's not obviously Welsh, particularly when I look.
Yeah, Dave mentioned Vic and Bob doing this.
I try and take.
I don't think I've seen that. I might have to look it up.
Possible, but obviously there aren't that many original. Local
reading out menus in a monotone doesn't get tougher than this. There we go. So there's just a snippet of MasterChef, a soupçon, if you will. Right, I'm going to choose then. Let's go take number three. Oh, take number three, which on the label says you. What's on the tapes? It's porn. No. Hang on, so does this have... Oh. Well, I don't like the look of this at all already. Just because I think it might be a more recent tape. Don't like the recent tapes. They annoy me. Just their existence offends me. The fact that I spent money on them offends me more. Wow. I'm always surprised by just how late people were using videotapes.
It's great that they've kind of looked at me and thought that I've got potential to go into London 2012 and do well there, so it's great that they're backing me and I look forward to it. It's great to be a part of it.
And it's coming closer and closer, and you get asked about it almost every day at the moment, so yeah.
No signal is the Elgato's way of, I mean, when the tracking is particularly bad, it just defaults to no signal.
I've just got to keep on training, I keep on dreaming, and if I am there, it'll be amazing. We're close to it now, I can nearly see the stadium, and every time I see it on TV, you know, see the adverts, watch programmes on it. I get really excited. It's a dream to be there.
Well, that's just about all for me. John's next with the weather, but for me, I'm the late teen. Good night.
I thought Calendar went out as a brand years ago. Like years and years and years ago. Yeah, I guess so. Save this tape when I'm doing this channel in 10 years. Yeah. Ah, thank you, Dave. I'll look at that after the stream.
Hello again.
Oh, thank you for subscribing, Gemma. I really appreciate it.
In this lovely cascading overflow down at the canal at Woodlesford there. Thank you very
much. Mind
you,
they had that London 2012 iconography in Doctor Who.
The rain that affected us today has southeastwards now. That's left us with...
They have the actual... I mean, they had London 2012 in Fear. I can't... Because it's a bad episode. Well, I don't think it's as bad as its reputation, but I've not watched it for a long time. So I can't tell you if they were using the logo and things, because it was 2006, so... I mean... I'm going to be honest, I don't care about this. I mean, this stream I care about, but this video, let's just go a couple of hours down, see if we can... Tracking on this tape does seem rather bad, doesn't it? Hugh Edwards' commentary drags it below... Bob, where have you gone? Or whatever the line was. You had a capture that would do that as well, dropping freight. Yeah, I was using a program originally called Golden Videos, which doesn't recognise the Elgato. I mean, now that I bought that.
Missile separation and for...
I don't know, but that's John Mahoney, isn't it? I mean, sorry, I probably should have at least stayed to find out what the film was, but... I just felt annoyed and cheated by the fact that it was You know, I saw ITV2 ads and things when I was flicking through. It's just there. It's a flame of hope and love. Yeah. Great film. That's Harrison Ford. Yeah, I had the Golden Videos program. It gives you an option of, because yeah, that recorder in particular skips frames, like if the tape's buggered.
I'll give you all the information that you need to play along with
that. Okay, this just got better. Ritter Collector Frantic, yeah, so it gets a bit like that when I'm just skipping through tapes. So is this ITV Player? Probably not. Oh, so, right, the film's called Frantic. Thank you, yeah. Yeah, I think the whole tape's pretty recent.
Welcome to Roulette Nation, those of you just joining us tonight for the first time. Welcome to The Zone. Indeed, this is The Zone. We are Challenge Jackpot and you are watching Roulette Nation. I'm Mel Peachy. That's enough of the introductions, I think. Shall we get started with a brand
so
new
So the Challenge Jackpot brand was dropped in 2011, but it launched on July 2008. So
you've never seen us before in your lifetime.
If I find the tape with the...
Well, you've missed out, let me tell you. But the good news is it's never too late because you can join us at any time, and tonight is a great time to do just that. So we play.
Yeah, so this is sometime between 2008 and 2011, which makes sense given the...
...hours of Roulette Nation tonight, all the way through on The Zone. So do make sure you stay with us.
So probably 2010 then.
3 in the morning, I believe, about 10 to 3. So do stay with us if you can.
Let's
if you
not.
Want to register and all that kind of stuff, we will let you know how that's done.
You watch this roulette live once, and when you tuned in, the zero came twice in a row.
So, what you have to do at home is predict where the ball will land.
It's almost like it's rigged.
Of our wheel. Let me introduce you to our wheel.
It's really not Quizmania, but it felt a lot like Quiz Call. I binged on those channels for quite a while in university. You know, I watched most of ITV Play Channel's launch day, and did they only last a day, or was it just Debbie King's show which only lasted a day? But yeah, I did call in a couple of times when Greg Scott was on. Actually, no, I don't think I did. No, I emailed in. I never actually called in. Used to set a videotape running on LP through the night on Quiz Call so you could check what the solutions were next morning. I mean, how did that work out for you? All right, trusty 25. I believe in tape 25. They eventually computerised the wheel, which made me think they'd just open themselves up to accusations of rigging. Yeah. Debbie King's show lasted one episode. Yeah, I can't remember whether it was the whole channel. Well, there's no points for telling me in the chat what film this is.
And now details on the sudden announcement that attracted the attention of the entire world. Hidden among the countless billions of water bars are five golden nuggets. And to the five people who find them will come the most fabulous prize.
You know that because Debbie King told us every night.
A lifetime supply of chocolate. And as if this were not...
Alright, let's go to the start of the tape, see what channel this is on if we can. Or if they've been naughty and taped it off the off a video, which I've found a few times. We all had a few of them, didn't we? I mean, ironically, I did have Ghostbusters 2 on as a hooky tape. Yeah, oh, hey, Matty, how you doing? Yeah, I quite enjoyed the web Quizmania. I mean, it wasn't wasn't quite the same, but yeah, it was fun. Sorry, Matt. Yeah, what can I say? My stream is not for the faint of heart.
And so the prince tried to rescue the beautiful Rapunzel.
Okay, I think this is that. You've got a few tapes in eBay boxes. I'm doing it, Babcock. Hello, thank you for joining. I'm bloody doing it. Oh. I mean, you thought me hitting the mic was bad on the ears. Oh.
And so the prince tried to rescue the beautiful Rapunzel from the witch's tower by climbing up her long, shining hair, which was as fine as spun gold.
Rapunzel, let down your hair. Rapunzel, let down your hair.
I'm sorry, all this Rapunzeling. Andy, there are far easier ways of getting into a castle than climbing up somebody's hair.
Look, Simon, when you're hunting ghosts, you just don't go through the front door.
All right, then, we'll go in through the back door.
Is it Ghostbusters 2?
Oh, no. Sorry, guard, we have actually got permission.
I think that was Caroline in the City, wasn't it? I love you.
Thank you.
I recognise this. I've never watched it, but I recognise the style from the DVD boxes.
The guards told me, but strangely enough, they wouldn't come with me. I wonder why.
He really doesn't, does he? Yeah, so it's an American show, 87, so, yeah.
You know what, Simon, I'm getting a bit worried about finding this ghost.
Andy, don't you worry. I mean, the second we find the ghost, your spirits will be lifted.
Terrible.
You know, all these ghosties and ghoulies, Dungeons and Dragons, they are beginning to frighten me a bit.
Simon Parkin, I think, isn't it?
Right to points of view.
Dear Anne, why, oh, why, oh, why?
I mean, come on, David, you should be telling us about how this is inaccurate as a ghost hunting video. You had a copy of Aladdin and Lion King that started halfway through the anti-piracy ad.
Is going to be a friendly ghost or not. It's important to do.
Fork Greville. Will he be a friendly ghost? Well, we haven't got time to look. I'm sure he will be.
Right, let's keep searching. Utter tripe and very offensive. Good. And that's good to know.
No picture, but an empty frame. Spooky, darlings.
Yeah, a lot of these people, when I look them up, they're local radio DJs now.
Look, Simon, I'm fed up of all this ghost hunting.
But Andy, it was your idea. You must stick with it. You must be a tower of strength.
That's it. The tower. That's where we'll find the ghost. Come on! Oh, come on, Simon.
I mean,
I'm just getting fed up of spiral staircases.
I don't know what we've walked in on.
I'm sure we'll find the ghost here, I promise. I think. Yeah, look, just come with me.
It is right up David's alley, and it wasn't planned at all.
Guy Fawkes Greville, haunted. No, Guy Fawkes, that was months ago, Simon. Hang on, I can hear something. No.
Now, look, I'll tell you what, I brought my pocket watch with me because apparently ghosts don't appear until after midnight and it's only just gone 10:35.
Is that true, David?
Andy, there's something I need to know.
What's that?
How big are your pockets?
It might have been around Halloween, I mean...
In turns, you wait an hour.
I don't know, this
I
seems
speak,
like the kind of thing that
I'll
could just happen any time of year.
Right. I'll wait an hour then.
Imagine they were mocking Doctor Who. That's how I feel. I hear you, man.
Simon, what? It's now 3:20.
It's David's time
it's
machine.
It's not going to come. Let's go.
No. Look, you've stayed here this long. You can do it. Who's afraid of a ghost anyway?
Simon, wake up. Wake up.
Christopher Eccleston was a good doctor, David. He was.
No. It's 5:30.
1989, yeah. How do you know that, Brian?
Isn't here.
No, I know.
Well, let's go now.
Oh, go now. I must go to the toilet. Excuse me.
You're not going to leave me here alone, are you?
Only be a minute.
He was a good doctor. I'm not going to... Let's leave it at that.
Simon! It's ghost! Who are you?
I am the ghost of CBBC Past.
What?
What do you want from me? I represent the old year and come to warn you of the new. I warn you of a formidable character who will come along and take the world by storm. He will be bold, dynamic, talented, handsome. He will have red hair.
It's not Donald Trump.
Red hair. Who are you trying to fool? What are you talking about?
Who am I trying to fool?
I am. I know it's you under here, Simon.
I like all the bakers.
I know.
There's very few doctors that I don't like these days.
Going to come. I was acting.
I'm not a massive Davison
fan. In that case, I'm going home. We'll have our New Year celebration food ready.
This is so involved, I love it.
Well,
it's a sketch
really
that should have ended ages ago. Bingo.
No, neither. I mean, what a complete waste of...
What noise? What noise?
Let's go.
Yeah, quick.
I bet you're impressed, Philippa.
Like
we were well hard there.
Philippa Forrester!
Anyway, top show tomorrow. What's going on?
Sorry. Philippa Forrester. Don't care.
Certainly ugly enough to be on the New Kids.
Yeah.
New Kids on the Block in Philadelphia. I was there. You can see it tomorrow morning, so make sure you don't
miss it. Now, tomorrow is New Year's Day, so I'm going to take the coal and the money, and I will let the New Year in tomorrow morning, 7 o'clock. Bye-bye.
But now Willy Wonka and the Chocolate Factory.
Okay. It's Philippa Forrester. I mean... Philippa Forrester, guys. Philippa Forrester. I once had a box with various pages I'd stolen from the News of the World that my dad used to buy, and just going to say it, Philippa Forrester topless beach pictures was one of those pages. I'm not proud, but I'm visualising them. It's etched on my memory. You know, they weren't particularly flattering photos, but did the job. How long is Willy Wonka from the chocolate? Sorry, guys. I'm not sorry. One hour 29 minutes. Disgusting. I know. I'm sorry. I'm not sorry. New Year's Eve. Okay. What year? On the beach.
It's a cheesy dinner.
It's Wonka Vision. It could change.
We're near the end. Of course, the weirdest given her career history was Gail McKenna popping up in Hell 2. Yeah, I know, Tom. I'm... Because PAL, NTSC, all this, yeah. PAL speed up. That's right.
Go ahead, Charlie.
Good, we missed the bit where he was a prick. I always hated that bit. No!
It's all at the Allied sale, now.
Oh. Oh, you bastard. I hate you, person who recorded this video.
You're giving Charlie that
I can't go on forever, and I don't really want to try. So, who can I trust to run the factory when I leave? And take
I
care
said
of the
good day.
Not a grown-up. Grown-up would want to do everything his own way, not mine.
I was really hoping to see a bit more Philippa Forrester. I think they actually did cut off the very end, yeah.
No, I use Flash.
Flash fights the dirt you can see and the germs you can't.
So now we've got this.
Fairy Liquid is so good at handling grease, it cuts it. To the squeak. Squeak after squeak after squeak.
Is that Valerie Singleton?
Why don't Zanussi recommend a single biological liquid? Because they recommend double biological aerial liquid.
It means nothing. Yeah, I know. Probably a timer record. Oh, we all did it.
Red company, halt!
I was just hoping they'd have left the channel running and we could see a few more. Wow.
This New Year's Day at 8:30 I've never seen people gutted to see adverts. The Curse of Mr. Bean will reveal a rather novel use for a hot water bottle.
Nanette Newman. Right, okay. Fair enough. Oh, it's straight Alice in Wonderland, but it's on a channel with ads, so this is exciting because it seems to be page 888 now. Oracle said must be.
I'm curious to know.
Yeah, I think Brian's about right. Some ads. It's alright, I'm over the Philippa Forrester thing, but I will be looking her up after the stream is finished.
Hello.
Quality seems very good considering the age. It often does.
And this was scarcely odd because they believed in everyone.
None of us are ever truly over Philippa, Ritter.
The time has come!
Oh, mate, I mean, yeah, I've had several tapes where people have cut out the ad breaks and as I've said repeatedly on this stream, thank you, an anonymous gifter. Really appreciate that.
A moral to it.
Oh, yes, a very good moral. If you happen to be an oyster...
Yeah, I used to be the person who cut out the ad breaks. And I'd be damn good at it, frankly.
Father William.
But really, I'm...
First verse. You are old Father William, the young man fed, and your hair has become very white. And yet you incessantly stand on your head. Do you think at your age it is right? It's right. Do you think at your age it is right? Well... In me, you, Father William, replied to his son. Do it again and again and again.
I'm sure I didn't rewind very far, but clearly I did.
Are all conditioners the same? Or does this leading brand leave towels much softer?
Or are you a washing detergent racist?
You're about to see.
One. Two. Three.
Statistically, one of those girls is now dead.
Four.
So which conditioner was it?
10 series of perfectly cut friends tapes.
It was, of course, Lenore. So much softer, you could see it.
That movie bumper was nice, now it'd be a Toyota bumper.
Here yeah. In Bedalsa soon, we realise that a hairspray that gives you great hope can sometimes let you down when it comes to the feel of your hair. The solution?
Points Bedalsa if you know who this dude
is. Of hairspray with a unique salon formula to give you a more flexible hold, so a look like Lisa's doesn't feel as stiff. And Sam can have a style that feels soft to the touch. Salon formula hairsprays from Bedalsa soon. Great hold. Never felt so good.
Robin Hood, you guys are on it. Robin from Maid Marian. Wow.
You just have to mother him with Vapor Rub until he gets better.
Follow the Vicks Vapor Rub 1-2-3 treatment. 1 on the back, 2 on the throat, 3 on the chest. Its vapors help
I mean,
the nose.
I'm starting to feel like this is where the current trend is on Pornhub came from.
Time for your Vapor Rub.
Him first. I feel better already.
Vicks Vapor Rub.
There's a generation of people for whom this ad awakened things, and they never got put back in the bottle.
She does it.
I do it.
They do it.
I do it. I don't think we're quite at that point yet, Tom.
Together we've done it.
Now everyone can afford to do their bit with Dixel 100% recycled family value. Tissues that don't cost the earth.
I have never, to my knowledge, used Dixel.
Ants always make me lick my chops.
Bum, 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 bum.
As yummy as Cocoa Pops, oh no. Bum, 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 bum.
I'd rather have a bowl of Cocoa Pops. There wasn't time for me to say to join in, but I
in
hope
the home world sale, we cut the price of
right?
every piece of furniture and hundreds of different electrical items. The Home World sale, open New Year's Day.
Hey, Santa, have you heard about Lumpolly's January sale? There's up to £150 off per
Really,
person.
Sarah?
£150 each? Get away.
You were coughing in Tisco and you nearly cleared the show. Oh, Choco Crispies, don't
How
get me started.
Ultra
Just
white without boil
still
washing.
Angry.
New Daz Ultra, the most powerful Daz ever.
Malcolm's got terrible feet. You can see how awful his socks get, especially after fishing.
And the song was so well loved that they had to try and keep the song.
You boil washed.
So it resulted for a while it resulted in I'd rather have a bowl of Choco Crispies.
The soot stained in tea gets only this white without the booster, but ultra white with Daz Ultra.
Angry.
The kids do karate on dirty wooden floors.
Thanks, Tom. You didn't have to bring this up.
They're smelly and grimy. I'm amazed how white it comes up.
You boil wash them, right?
No. Daz Ultra.
For a white, you could almost mistake for boil wash white.
I don't know what region these ads are from, actually.
Right.
I've not been paying enough attention. They're from Disney region. Oh. Yeah, could well be Yorkshire. I don't know where this particular tape came from, so...
And the slide...
Sorry, what's this? I'd rather have a bowl of Cocoa Pops was a phrase used by BBC host to sync ISDN broadcast with a co-host in another location. One would start the phrase and the other would try and get Cocoa Pops in the right timing. I know that for a fact. Wow.
It's very funny.
Thank you, Olivia. That is very niche and very interesting information. You're cancelled, Dan. Didn't we have a calendar local news on the... yes, but the other tape wasn't connected to this tape, so...
Idea. Yeah. As you would say...
I've got tapes from all over the place.
Herbs and spice.
There we go.
All the silly nonsense. This is the stupidest tea party I've ever been to in all my life.
Me. Stuck up cow.
We take herbs and we take spices to make that special taste.
Only Kentucky Fried Chicken has the secret blend of 11 herbs and spices. No wonder it's the world's favorite.
Back when it was Kentucky Fried Chicken, of course.
The taste that can't be beat.
I mean, I've never had a KFC that looks anything like
in
that.
The taste.
And if the teletext recovery screws up, you often
Everyone
end up with
knows
your shite
on the powders
mean
page. Less
nice.
Chemicals, less packaging, and less waste. But do they mean less cleaning power too? Not at all. New Radeon Micro. A concentrated powder
KFC
with unbeatable performance.
At market. Hey,
with around half the powder, Radeon Micro gets your clothes really clean because it removes tough stains and odours, even the microscopic traces of stale odour that other concentrated powders miss. The result?
Wow.
Looks clean.
You both come in and injure each other. Wow.
And a lot less powder, too.
New Radeon Micro, unbeatable at removing dirt
steam.
And odours.
Where's the bucket of oil
I
dip it in, says Dave?
Or Nagam PB.
She's the girl that may make the thing that holds the oil, that oils the ring, that takes the shank, that moves the crank, that works the thing of me bob. It's a tingly sort of job, making a thing for a thing of me bob, especially when you find out what it's for. But she's the girl that makes the thing that fills the hole, that holds the spring, that works the thing of me bob, that makes the engines roar. And it's the girl that makes the thing that holds the oil. The ring that makes the thingamabob that's going to make some more.
And you thought we just made television thingamabob.
Oh, mate, you ruined it. Sorry, I really like that advert and I want to watch it again. Until that guy said the thing at the end. I was enjoying the nice little song, the wacky vision. Yeah. But the guy coming in at the end, that's not right.
Looks clean, smells clean, and a lot less powder too.
New Radion Micro, unbeatable at removing dirt and odours.
I make these chicken balls for Nikon PB.
She's the girl. I was a bit worried at that point where we were going with this. But how not to treat a vintage CRT TV.
Especially when you find out what it's for. But she's the girl that makes the thing that fills the hole that holds.
Oh, it's a reconditioned old World War II song, is it?
The engines roar. And it's the girl that makes the thing that holds the oil that oils the ring that makes the thing that's going to make some more.
And you thought we just made television thingamabob.
Mate.
Tony, stop it glowing!
Hey, your secret. Stop glowing. Glowing! Glowing! Oh no, Tiger Man!
So Blade Runner. Hey, Walter, it's Adrian.
Tony, kill frosties have the secret formula that makes them...
Great! That's a rubber tree.
Once again, there's so many people in here, and I'm grateful to every single one of you.
They're great!
Secret formula, sugar. Yeah. Oh, which was the one that had the advert? Mummy, wow, I'm a big
with
boy
its
now.
With long-lasting strength.
Makes the thingamabob that's going to win the war.
Vortex
right. Okay.
Protects.
That makes sense.
After bathing, some soaps leave scummy stuff behind, which could dry your baby's skin.
Huggies pull-ups, right, I'll have to look that up.
Behind, but baby soft
yeah,
skin.
I remember singing that advert
we
a lot as a kid.
We experts recommend InfoCare. It leaves nothing behind but smooth, soft skin.
It's not an that's an ugly baby.
Mrs. Thomas has a very sore throat, but Chloraseptic contains a very fast-acting painkiller. But is it fast enough
Peter
to
Jones?
Start to work before we finish this commercial? Well, Mrs. Thomas?
That's amazing.
Not that Peter Jones, that the good Peter Jones. Wow. Oh, this is LP as well, apparently. Which, if I'm honest, is slightly annoying, because I want to my late dad used to sing the nappies out, I'm a big girl's blouse. David says, I love seeing all these products which are almost definitely banned now. Yeah. Oh, a crow in a Disney movie, that never ends well. Here we go, Whisk, tougher on stains, gentle on colours. LP is less good for storing... Thora heard. I'm a horrible person. Just gonna say it. The Mellow Men. That's Yorkshire.
Never been the same since that incident with the
Wesley Dale
and the Jack Russell.
Oh. We'll never know what happened there.
Whisk has been improved. Now it's even tougher on stains. Still just as gentle on colours.
Is that Roger Allen?
I shouldn't laugh, but the Vicar's never been the same since that incident with the Wesley Dale and the Jack Russell.
Anyway, you please it, cheese it.
What?
Runny nose, sore throat, coughs, sneezes.
Who man? Don't. Say good riddance. The layman will not be able to get teletic stuff off. I asked, and yeah.
Churchill could save you money on your car insurance. Call one of our people now and see how much you
Winter
could save.
You'll be surprised. Yeah.
Call Churchill free on 0800 200 300 for an instant.
I think you get a lot of winter ads for this kind of thing, because right? kids'
That's
films,
right.
they show a lot
free
of them around
on 0800
Christmas.
200 300.
Call Churchill now and see how much you could save free on 0800 200 300.
A pre-nodding dog church lad, yeah? Okay. Tom, I'm assuming people have tried all kinds of other capture cards that aren't that particular capture card.
Yeah. Right, I'm off.
Oh, Linda Bellingham.
Friday night. And don't forget to remind your father that he's picking me up.
Okay.
That hat won't protect him.
I've got to go. Oh, Mum says to remind Dad.
What about?
It's Friday night. That being picked up.
Oh, yeah.
I'm breathing. I'm starving.
Where's some chilli? Just bunk it in the microwave. Oh, yeah. Message from Mum. Remember, it's tonight, and tell Dad about being picked up, all right?
Just what the doctor ordered.
Mum said it would pick you up. Oh, and don't forget, tonight's the night.
It's vasectomy time.
So, tonight's the night, then.
Gosh.
Yeah, Lam Polly are offering up to £150 each of their summer holidays. Get away.
This is strangely comforting. They are, aren't they, Popstar?
Double.
There's a reason why I seem to be getting way more viewers than I've ever had my gaming streams. So we've had a Wednesdaydale advert, a double Gloucester advert.
This afternoon at 1:30 on ITV, the Disney premiere of Tron,
wow.
A future world of danger, destruction, and death.
You're getting brutal, Sark. Brutal and needless and sadistic.
Thank you, Master Control.
I would defo expect my daughters to tell me I'm going to have a shag tonight. Yeah.
Enter the world of Tron this afternoon.
Nice.
And at 12:25 this afternoon, Sophie is finding it hard to live down her father's crime in Home and Away.
Very abrupt, that. Who knows when this tape is from? That Tron looks so futuristic. Preferred neighbor. Oh, I mean, Neighbours pissed all over Home and Away. But fun fact, Amazon Prime Instant Video does have, like, the first 2 years of Home and Away now on their streaming service. I watched about 20 minutes of the first episode. And I thought, I'm all right not watching 2 years of Home and Away.
Bodger, perhaps, could...
Oxo, Tonight's the Night, 1989. Okay. So it's probably, December 1989. Hey, Weetos. 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 There's a bit of ghosting on this bit. Got completely hooked. I mean, I got hooked on Neighbours for a few years. I think there's no shame in these things. It's just... by their nature, they're addictive. I mean, that's kind of the point of soap operas, too. They get you and they keep you coming back every day.
It had been a near thing for Bodger. Weak
we watched
was,
all of the soaps at one point. But now we'd watch Neighbours, then we'd go to Home and Away.
He would bring the meal so
then
badly.
There'd be a short break before we had Emmerdale, Corrie, EastEnders, The Bill. Fast forward as it should be. Yep. Yeah, I think I'm just going to give my tapes to Tom. I love you. Telltale dot. I did watch Star Trek Next Generation. Hey, Verna. By himself again,
revived and refreshed, and ready for the road.
You're still hooked on it. Well, good for you, Coogee Bear, Sarah.
Keep calm. Nobody panic.
Yes, looks like an insurance.
I know they've got.
Job.
I kind of read the stories on Digital Spy about neighbours. That's enough for me.
You only find out how good an insurance company is when you make a claim.
Hello, this is Direct Line.
With Direct Line, you deal with a human being, yes, not a blank form.
Definite, genuine Direct Line employee.
Provides low-cost insurance for over a quarter of a million motorists.
So we can authorise the repair immediately.
Thank you.
Actually, based on my brief experience of working in a call centre, there were a lot of out-of-work actors there, so could well be. Direct Line before it was online.
All animals develop special senses to survive. Sometimes we need to use those senses in our domestic lives. Say there was a gas leak. Use your nose.
No, Pops, this isn't my box. My box is long gone. This is my box that I bought off eBay in January, and I bought several boxes.
Use your eyes.
And I've got about 400 tapes now.
See the doors and windows are open.
Yeah. Harold Bishop Thurman.
Use your common sense.
He fell off a cliff and came back.
Don't
think it was quite 10, but it was a while.
Don't touch any electrical switches, not even doorbells.
And then he was in. He stayed in it for a very long time
straight away. Don't leave it to anyone else.
Well, this is a piff, yeah.
No matter what time it is, British Gas will be there as fast as humanly possible.
Definitely seems that way, doesn't it?
Engineers.
He did fall off a cliff, didn't he? I mean, I know. He got washed away at sea. That was the... This just became a perfect Friday. 30-year-old had beer and chocolate. I'm glad, Ben. I think he fell off some rocks rather than a cliff, but... That's depressing,
that
isn't
one,
it? The Harvey Keitel thing.
Yeah. The freeze guy fly in every bag of Weedos.
Is that Bill Oddie? A trick, though. Wow. Washed off some rocks, okay. Did sound like Oddie, didn't it? Oh, come on.
I'm a gerbil, and I'm very careful about what I eat.
I favour extreme regime.
I'm a gas potato, and I'm on a balanced diet. Chips with burgers, chips with curry, chips on toast.
I'm into regular exercise and a regular diet. Oh. So I go for bird's eye.
Adam Morris again.
Especially the chicken korma. Low fat, with no artificial colours or preservatives.
Why be a gerbil or a couch potato?
Chips with chips.
Harold did have some bizarre storylines.
Take the healthy option.
Yeah, Madge came back to him as a ghost.
Huddersfield, well, half price sale now on, with many reductions in all departments.
Hallucination, I did watch some of that.
The independent men's and ladies' fashion stores, King Street, Huddersfield.
They did the ghost thing a few times. Wow. Right, we're getting very near to 9 o'clock, so I'm going to fast forward through to the hopefully the end of the film, just to see if there's anything more program wise, because we all enjoy the ad, but. Who knows what gold's waiting at the end of the film, and it'll be a real shame.
But this is only half of...
Hey, Flephosaurus. Every time they pour fabric conditioner in these ads, I can't help but think it looks delicious. I mean, Tide Pods. You know.
Vintage Wicker Way Out West. Next Sunday at 8 on 4.
Oh, are we on Channel 4 now?
In half an hour, Spike and Linda have a very important deadline to meet in Press Gang. First, pull up your chair close to the fire. and listen to a story, bitter and sweet, all at once.
Was Jim Henson? Nice.
When people told themselves their past with stories, explained their present with stories, foretold the future with stories, the best place by the fire was kept for the storyteller.
Nice. I mean, they're all available online. But that is a good, that's a good find. Oh, Suala, yeah.
Listen, daughter. Last night, your father and I went to...
Still can't believe she dated Richard Herring. I mean, nothing against the guy, but...
Favourite?
Julia Suala, man.
Walked the world to find
you. You had this on one of your eBay tapes, but the tape was really squeaky and mouldy, so you binned it. That's fair.
The fire was kept for the storyteller.
These are tapes that I bought, Chef. Okay, so I guess we're not...
The tale of a young boy who, having never experienced fear, sets out...
When people told themselves their past...
So is this just the tape that they use to record lots of Storyteller on after this? 4:36. It's coming to an end now, so... Yeah, you say by all accounts, by his accounts. I mean, let's... you know. So there could literally be anything on them. And that is the joy of what's on the tapes. You know, you could get a broom cupboard, you could get an art house Derek Jarman film. You just don't know. Joaquin Phoenix has a crush on Julius. I don't think it does, Tom. Or maybe... What does Index Search do? Thank you, Chef. It just kind of happened.
The Storyteller,
and it's turning out really well. From bookshops. Incredibly great. And unfortunately, we're near the end of it now. But
Cindy Watkins won't
I do
tell
have
exactly
previous
what her home
streams archived
are,
on YouTube.
His suspicions remain until help comes
and yeah,
from
follow
an
Twitter
source.
To find out. And the next one almost certainly won't be until Wednesday now. Like TOS Roulette. Yeah, we've got
Desmond's
close.
In the
but...
doghouse.
If you do that, I never speak to you.
Yeah, the next
again.
Stream is going to be Wednesday at 7:30 because I'm now working.
This couple
the next
spied
4 days,
the Russians from
so...
this house in the heart of English suburbia.
Yeah.
Now
by the time
Russia,
I finish on a work day, I don't want to do a stream.
Sacrificed everything for life in the Soviet Union. Anything to declare? There's no hiding from the Eurocrats.
Don't you remember? We saved you in the war.
Tomorrow on 4.
Index Search finds the next recording. Okay, that's interesting to know. And there we go. That is the end of the tape. And it's 20:59. That is almost perfect for when I plan to end the stream. CJ, you've come in the dying moment, but thank you. Provided the tape has it, of course. I know, man. But it's all available on YouTube. YouTube.com. tinyurl.com/WOTTYT. That'll take you to the YouTube channel. This is all free. It's always going to be free. But if you do fancy subscribing, if you do fancy donating via PayPal, you can use that link up there. I'm never going to pressure you. For what it's worth, I do like the I'll do a stream when I feel like it. Yeah, I think I like to have at least one scheduled stream. But I'm also, you know, I think this is... Yeah, I've kind of messed around with formats a bit, and I think just doing sort of videos and, you know, doing sort of pre-recorded videos, it's not as fun. You know, I don't have all you guys here. It's not quite as good. So, yeah. Thank you all for coming. Follow the Twitter. I'll hopefully post some clips. Generally, when I've got work days, I tend to end up clipping bits in the sort of downtime and putting them up on YouTube, and I'll probably put some of the stuff from tonight up on Twitter and things. Yes, thank you so much, everyone. Watch the replays, guys. Some gold. Yeah, certainly Wednesday's one was amazing. We had a full broom cupboard, pretty much full broom cupboard, from I think 1987 it was, and a real awkward moment starring Michael Barrymore. I'll leave it at that. Yeah, I'm off to watch Star Trek Picard and chill out. Yeah, thank you. All the links up there, and I'll see you all again next Wednesday, 7:30. Bye.